G'day punters, Blake from the Leg Up Australia. Wednesday, we had a cracking day. We went bang early on with Wacker winning at $3.90. Then we backed it up with Nick O'Shea getting onto a drier surface and winning for us after being well backed at $3.30. And then we finished off with Travancore winning on Rachel King's birthday at $3.30. So it was an absolute fill up for the punters on Wednesday at Warwick Farm for us. Saturday, they're racing at Randwick, currently on a heavy nine surface. There is a little bit of rain forecast between now and then. Saturday is going to be dry and fine, sunny, 21 degrees, so hopefully it dries out a little bit on Saturday, but it won't get any worse than it is right now. So working on a heavy eight, heavy nine surface for the meeting at Randwick on Saturday. I think the best bet of the day comes up in the seventh race. It's number two, Haunted, from the James Cummings stable. McAvoy's in the saddle. He was freshened up and they took him to Grafton for the listed Ramorny. He just absolutely had no luck. He missed the start and then he couldn't find clear galloping room in the straight. He looked like he had plenty to offer. He was a good thing beat. We were on him there and he just did not get a crack at them. 1,300 meters back to handicap conditions is absolutely ideal for him. There's enough speed in the race. I think he can just get in behind them and have a cushy run. And then when McAvoy produces him, he just should be too good for them. He's got a little bit of heavy track form. He's got one win and a third. The third was behind 50 stars in Melbourne. So that's all right for this. He should handle the heavy track. McAvoy will find a good spot on him, and he just think he's just going to be too good for them. So that's Randwick Race 7, Haunted, to make amends for his horrible beat in the Ramorny. I think the value bet comes up in the 8th race. It is number 4, Monsieur Sisu. I know this horse doesn't win very often, and he disappointed last start. But he gets his chance back onto a heavy track up to 1,800 meters. I just think he is marked way longer than he should be. He started favorite behind Attention Run, two back over 1,600 meters. He was really game that day. And then he was on the worst part of the track last start when he got onto a soft six surface. And he was a little bit disappointing. But the horses that beat him all come down the outside. That was Pelothronius and horses like that. So he was in the worst part of the track. I think he gets his chance, and I just think he is triple the odds that he should be. Probably should be about 7 or 8 to 1, and currently we're getting $17 about him, and we can back him each way. He's going to go forward. He runs into a track that he's going to like, a heavy 9 or a heavy 8, and I just think he represents a bit of value. He has met the favourite Cyber Intervention before over a mile and a quarter. He got beat 3.3 lengths by her that day, but that was on a soft 7 surface, and he gets about a 5 or 6 kilo weight swing on her for that beaten margin. I do think Cyber Intervention has improved from last preparation, but she runs into a heavy track. She's up to 1,800 meters. I just don't want to be taking the shorts on the heavy track. If it was a good track, I would be all over her, but on the heavy surface, I'm going with Monsieur Sisu. I think he represents nice value. So that's Randwick Race 8, number 3, Monsieur Sisu. My hardest to beat comes in the last race. He's added a little bit of value. It is Race 9, number 2, Thy Kingdom Come, from the John Thompson stable. Huey Bowman rode him first up and he sticks with him again. He just peaked on his effort and he raced a little bit green first up. He got back and he wanted to run in behind them when he got a little bit tired, but he did loom up like he was going to run right into the race. That was behind Handle the Truth. I think he strips fitter for that effort and I think he's going to race on the speed. 1,400 meters suits him second up and he usually does improve with a run under his belt. He performed really well on two occasions last preparation on soft surfaces. So we're going to be getting into the soft, heavy, soft sort of going on Saturday. So that's going to suit him. As I said, Huey's in the saddle. He was unlucky a couple of times last preparation. So he did win two races last preparation, but I think he probably could have won four with even luck. So he's going really nicely. I think he improved second up, and I just think we got a bit of value about him at $7.50. So that's Randwick Race 9, number 2, Thy Kingdom Come. Thanks for watching. I've got three things for you before I let you go. Don't forget to check out our brand new website, www.thelegupaustralia.com. If you haven't yet subscribed to our mailing list, please do. You can head over to the website, click the link to subscribe, and you'll get all my tips on Saturday for the meeting at Randwick. And that's about it from me. If you are going to have a bet on Saturday, please do so responsibly. And as always, good luck.